Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Friends of the Feather. And there's one of our friends now. It is a wonderful day. It's Mental Monday. I started this morning talking about acorn flour, and I spelled it wrong in that video. I've got a couple things to add to that video. I spelled acorn wrong. It's E-I-N-K-O-R-N, acorn. That's the name of the flour. In the previous video, I posted a link to the flour and to the recipe that I followed. In that recipe, also, I wanted to point out that you do not need a mixer for that. That's one of the reasons that I stopped attempting to bake bread was because I didn't have a mixer, and I was trying to use a hand mixer, and I basically burned it up trying to use that on bread dough and other doughs, and it didn't work out. So I was waiting because I really want a KitchenAid 5-quart tilt head mixer in chrome specifically, and I haven't been able to get that because those are not cheap. So the reason that I hadn't tried this previous, because I've known about this flour for some time, and the reason that I hadn't tried it previous to this is because I thought that you would need a mixer because of how thick and dense the flour is, but you do not. And that is very, very awesome. And another reason that I'm quite the fan. Yeah, we've got some chasing going on here. We've got rooster versus rooster. Thankfully, Oswald is pretty quick. He's a pretty quick guy. We've got Mr. Panty over here. He reminds me of like one of those typecast Italian mob bosses that, like, when he tries to walk too fast, he gets way out of breath and sweaty. Yeah, that's what he reminds me of. So if you're wondering what they're pecking at, it's their own shells. I know that's pretty morbid, but it's good for them. I also have a cucumber that had gone a bit bad. I try to catch them before they get too bad. That one wasn't too bad, so they seem to be enjoying the shells. This is the first time I've done this. We got 5 eggs today. Big news, 5 eggs. That's great news. I have eaten more of the acorn flour, and again, it hasn't made me feel sluggish or weird. It gives me energy, actually. I ate a piece at like 1 o'clock with some butter, and that got me through. I ate just a few minutes ago because I felt like I probably should. It was like 6:30, and I was like, you know, I should probably eat something, but I really wasn't hungry. So I'm thinking that flour is where it's at. Like, it keeps you full. Well, excuse me, sir. Mr. Biggs over here. So, I'm feeling pretty good about it. We're going to use it sparingly, as bread should be used. It's a treat. It's not something I'm going to start eating a loaf a day or anything. I feel like there's going to be some... Yeah, he's pretty quick, big guy. He's pretty quick. Man, Fiddle is on the prowl. But yeah, I feel really good about it. And I think that another thing that I wanted to talk about, because it is Mental Monday, is the importance of vacations. It's really, really important to get away every once in a while. Like this whole week, I was going to do videos, and I actually like, the morning that we left, when we were at the gas station, I shot like a 4-minute video explaining what we were doing and where we were going, and I was like, you know what, I'm just not going to do this. Because I didn't want to interrupt the moment, I guess, just any of the moments that I had, because I have such a good time with upper management. Just anywhere we go, anything we're doing, I have a really good time with him, and I didn't want to be preoccupied with that, and like trying to get him posted, and I didn't really have internet access, like for my laptop a lot of the time, and so that was a big hindrance. I was really We saw a lot of really cool stuff, and I thought it would have been really cool to do that. But alas, I did not follow through. Falky balky. So vacations are very important. I see these studies they post all the time about, you know, the percentage of Americans that don't take their full vacations, and how, like, that's a really big problem in countries like Japan. Their citizens don't want to take vacations because they're so dedicated to their workplace, I guess. I mean, I'll have to say that I love my job. I love what I do. But I think it's still important to get away every once in a while. Even if you're just like a stay-at-home mom, if you're a stay-at-home wife and you don't do anything, you don't work or anything, I think a break in that routine is really important, to just kind of sit back and reflect on how your routine has been going and see places where you would like to make improvements or changes, or see places where you can make changes. I think it's really, really important to do that. So I just wanted to mention that, because I took this vacation, and again, it was like hitting a little reset button. I don't feel like I was in any kind of distress or anything, but it's more of like it gives me a minute to scroll out on things and kind of take a minute to breathe and reflect on where I'm at and what I want to do. I'm pretty pleased with where everything is. So yeah, I would love to help everyone. I told upper management while we were away, because of, I feel like I've finally figured it out, like the weight loss thing. I finally figured it out. I figured out why I couldn't lose weight. I figured out why it was clinging to me like some kind of, what, Fiddle, you better be cool. He's back here lurking, and it makes me a little nervous, I'll have to say. He's a big boy, and some of them do like to fly and try to get my head. I want to point that out, too. So, but anyway, I want to try and share what has happened to me. And I don't know what key was... It feels like a switch was flipped in my head. And it, like, the key has been there the whole time, and I just didn't know it. So I feel like I want to share that with people, but I don't know how. And I told upper management that I felt like those, like when you see those movies about people who find Jesus and they become like super evangelical, and they go around and they try to bring everybody into the fold that they run into, and they just start, you know, screaming from the rooftops about the wonders of Jesus. Like, that's the way I feel about this. It's like, I just want to tell everybody, like, how I did it, and I want everyone to be able to do it. But, it's not easy. I had talked to a friend just a little bit ago it was like 3 days ago, I had told her what I was doing, because she saw me, and she was just like, oh my God, you've lost so much weight. And I was like, yeah. And I was kind of explaining to her a little bit what I'd been doing with, like, you know, eating more meats and, you know, just meat and veg and making sure that it's good, clean food and, you know, that kind of thing. And I saw her like 3 weeks later, and this was 3 weeks ago or 3 days ago that I saw her, 3 weeks after the initial conversation. And she was like, oh my goodness, I've been trying that, and it's so hard. It's just, it's so difficult. I don't know how you do it. It's, the cravings are so bad. I just want to eat all the time. So I told her I was eating once a day, and I was just eating meat and veg, pretty decent meal at the end of the day. And that was it, you know, and I drink a lot of water. I keep myself active through the day, and I just don't think about food, or I try to keep myself preoccupied and not think about food. She's having a very difficult time. And I feel bad, because I didn't really have a hard time with it. It's almost like I feel like I was handed a gift. I feel like the revelation that I had about food and what was keeping the weight on me, I feel like someone handed me like the keys to the kingdom. I feel like I've been handed a gift, and I don't know what it was. I don't know how it happened. It just came to me and started kind of setting in gradually. And now I feel like I've got it figured out. and it feels wonderful. It feels so good. The mystery is finally solved. So that's really, really cool. And so I will go on about it quite a bit, and I'm going to try not to as much as, you know, I'm going to try not to go on too much, but I will be talking about a lot. So mostly on Mental Mondays, I think, because it has helped my mental state in many so just enormous ways. I can't even really, I can't put them all into one video. So, all right, guys, that's it for our Mental Monday today. My ramblings of a mad woman. Make sure you guys comment. Make sure you guys like. Make sure you subscribe. Thank you so much to our 130 subscribers. I greatly appreciate it. We're trying to get to 1,000 so we can monetize, so I can expand on this beast here and get some more of these beasts. Oh, I got a new enclosure for the buttons, and I'll be debuting that tomorrow. So they're going to be moved down here with everyone else so we can get them in on videos too. So, all right, guys, have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.